Hey, I'm Carl Dix. I'm with the Revolutionary Communist Party, and I'm having another dialogue with Cornel West on October 29th up in Harlem. Our theme is going to be In the Age of Obama, Part 2. Police terror, incarceration, no jobs, miseducation, what future for our youth? Cornel and I began this conversation last year when we dialogued over the ascendancy of Obama and the continued need for resistance and liberation. Just like last year, we're going to have some straight talk over some crucial questions. It's going to be serious and it's going to be a lot of fun. I urge you to be there. Now, Cornel, he's a heavy brother who has a lot of heartfelt concern for the masses, and he ain't afraid to speak truth to power. He undoubtedly will have some illuminating things to say. For my part, my message will be both simple and urgent. Every day here in New York City, the cops stop and harass more than 1,600 people. Most of the people they stop are young. 84% are black or Latino, and more than 90% were doing nothing wrong when the cops stepped to them and jacked them up. They do this under a policy called stop and frisk, a policy that's illegal and illegitimate. The cops jokingly call this ground and pound, as if the way they throw so many of our youth to the ground and brutalize them is something to laugh at. This is a concentration of the brutality and misery this system enforces on our youth. This is the future this system has in store for our youth, a future without hope or purpose, no matter who is president, a future of dying and killing, either fighting each other on the streets here or joining the military and being trained to massacre people all over the world, no matter whether the Democrats or the Republicans control Congress. But things don't have to be this way. I'm part of a force that's standing up to all the hell they bring down on us. I'm part of a force that's pointing the way to a totally different and far better future for society and the world. We in the Revolutionary Communist Party are building a movement for revolution, a movement that aims to put revolution on the map in this country, to introduce people to the leader we have for this revolution in Bob Avakian, and to bring forward a core of determined fighters for this revolution. We are building a movement for revolution that mobilizes people to resist the sharpest attacks being brought down. And we wage this resistance in ways that expose the illegitimacy of this system. And we do it in a way to give people a glimpse of a different way for society to be organized and run, and a different way for people to relate to each other. Yeah, the revolutionary forces are small today, but revolutions always start small. The key thing is, this movement is boldly spreading revolution everywhere and mobilizing people to fight the power and transform themselves and others for revolution. And a big part of this revolution is all about dialoguing with, debating with, and learning from people like Cornel, people who agree with us on some things and don't agree with us on some other stuff. Now look, I know a lot of the youth are into some bad shit. Well, this revolution is real, and it's the only way to get them out of that shit and into something that's worthwhile. And it's the only way to end all this madness people are forced to endure every day and open up a bright future for humanity. Lectures about youth pulling up their pants or getting with God will do nothing to change things, no matter whether these lectures are given by Barack Obama or by Bill Cosby. Now, this is what I'm going to be talking about on October 29th. So if you're ready for some straight talk on what the real problem is and how to really solve it, you need to be at the Harlem stage on the campus of the City College of New York on Friday, October 29th at 7 p.m. And if you're not ready for that kind of straight talk, I suggest you just stay your ass home that night and work on convincing yourself that this time getting behind the Democrats won't work out the way it's always worked out before, with people's desire for change being sold out again and people's hopes being dashed to the ground. Again, that's In the Age of Obama, Part 2. Police terror, incarceration, no jobs, miseducation. What future for our youth? A dialogue between Cornel West and Carl Dix. And it's happening on Friday, October 29th at 7 p.m. at the Harlem stage on the campus of the City College of New York. Be there.